As we will discuss the hadith inshallah after this phone call. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Sister Ammar from the KSA.
Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh.
Alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
I'm Ammar from KSA. How are you, Sheikh?
I'm fine, alhamdulillah. Thank you for asking and thank you for calling Sister Ammar. Go ahead.
Thank you, Sheikh. I've been watching a couple of your programs on internet and Facebook. I need to ask some of the questions from for the upcoming Hajj and Umrah.
Yeah.
I have my parents, they are intending to travel from Toronto, Canada to Jeddah to perform Umrah. They are staying only for 10 days in Jeddah. Now my question is, do they need to have put the ihram from Toronto airport? Because my father is aged about 70 years, he intends to take one day rest in Jeddah, then put the ihram from Jeddah and then carry on for the Umrah.
Yeah.
Now my question is, he has to put ihram from Toronto airport, or can he put after taking one day's rest in Jeddah, can he put ihram from Jeddah? That is one question.
Mm-hmm.
He wants to do Umrah and then get back to his country. He is not coming for the Hajj. My second question is, I know how this constructed. Now how to go, what is the sunnah style to get into the house? Apart from throwing a party for the relatives or the families, or is there some sunnah thing which we need to perform, or should we read or recite Surah Bakara or Surah Imran repeatedly in the home? How to go about start living in a new house so that we will make dua or read Quran or what? Like, I just need to know.
No.
These are my two questions, Sheikh. Thank you very
much. Ammar, can you hear me, Sister Ammar? Ammar?
All the Muslims in trouble.
Can you hear me? Okay, I assume not. Barakallah fiki. As far as your first question, your father was coming from Toronto, Canada to perform Umrah. Meanwhile, he will stop by in Jeddah for a few hours or a day, stay with you, then resume his journey to perform Umrah. I was about to ask you which airline that he's flying with. Because I can advise him with something to make it easy for him. This advice would apply to every passenger who's flying from a long distance. If you're taking a flight which would have to take a transit in any of the Middle Eastern countries, so don't worry about putting the ihram on from Toronto, Washington DC, Houston Airport, or JFK in New York. Basically, because when you reach to any of these countries, you can change into the ihram outfit, which is the izar and the rida, in the transit airport. Then when you board the plane, normally the captain announces that if you're planning to perform Umrah or whenever it's Hajj season, we are in line with the miqat. Even if you decided to assume the intention of ihram before reaching the miqat, it is permissible. But I'm not really sure if there is a direct flight from Toronto to Jeddah, but if there is, then in this case, since he's coming to perform Umrah and that is in his intention as the sole purpose, and meanwhile he will visit you, then he should not cross the miqat without assuming the intention of ihram. So the options will be limited to either, if he wants, he can change into the ihram outfit in Toronto, and that means he will stay in ihram ihram outfit, which does not necessarily mean that he in a state of ihram for approximately 11 hours. Then before an hour or so before entering into Jeddah airport, he will declare the intention of the actual ihram, where he would withhold from doing any of the restrictions of ihram. The second option is, if he's traveling business class, for instance, or first class, it would be a lot easier where he can find a room to change into the ihram in the airplane, in the aircraft. Otherwise, he should not cross the miqat, the appointed area of entering into ihram, without commencing into the act of ihram by saying labbaika umratan. Barakallahu fiqh.